So good morning students. So today we will discuss about what is boundary layer and how the boundary layer is formed. So just basic idea. So first of all, what we do, we consider a real fluid with small viscosity and it is moving along this particular direction, and this fluid is moving with the velocity capital U. That velocity is called the free stream velocity, or sometimes it is called the undisturbed velocity. And this is the solid body. You see, the structure is like the wing of an aeroplane. So what happens when a fluid moves past this surface? Then Prandtl, from his experiment, has shown that the fluid sticks at the surface of the body. Okay. So what does it imply? Sticks at the surface of the body means the relative velocity at the surface is zero. Now what is the meaning? Velocity of the fluid minus velocity of the surface is equal to zero. So if the surface is at rest, then at the surface the fluid velocity will be zero, and if the surface is moving at certain velocity, then at the surface the fluid velocity will equal to the velocity of the surface at that point. Then it is seen that if we go away from the surface, that is along the perpendicular direction, the velocity is increasing. At the surface, the velocity is zero. Then its velocity is increasing up to a certain layer, up to a certain region. But beyond that region, the velocity will not be changed with the direction of that particular moving. So suppose if you consider this direction as your x-axis, that is along the length of the surface, and this one is your y direction, okay, then the velocity will be changed or increased up to a certain level, and beyond that level there will not be any change in the velocity profile or value of the velocity. So what we have seen that there is a velocity gradient, means change of velocity along the direction. So there is a velocity gradient exist only velocity gradient exist in only in a certain region. Okay, this region is called boundary layer. Okay, this region is called, so how in simple word, what is boundary layer? When a fluid moves around any closed surface, then in the neighborhood of the surface there exists an imaginary layer. You remember, imaginary layer, in the naked eye you cannot see that layer. So there exists an imaginary layer in the neighborhood of the surface where there exists a velocity gradient, and beyond that layer there will not be any velocity gradient, means beyond that layer there will not be any change in velocity along the perpendicular direction, because you are taking you are measuring all this along y axis, that is the perpendicular direction. Okay, now one more important point, you see, from your first unit or from your constitutive equation, if you see that your viscous stress is equal to mu times velocity gradient, or you can see that your del u del y type, okay, del u del y plus del v del x. Now as you have said, the flow is only along x axis, so v is zero. So whatever that, the viscous stress is equal to mu into velocity gradient. Now within the layer there is a velocity gradient, so there exists shear stress within that particular boundary layer. But shear stress within layer means within the boundary layer. But outside the region, there is no velocity gradient. So outside the region, tau is equal to zero. So from this point, from this, what we can say that inside the boundary layer, there exists shear stress, and shear stress is connected with the internal friction. Okay. So within the layer, the presence of viscosity is dominant, but outside the layer, you can neglect the viscosity. Okay. So in case of real fluid with small viscosity, okay. Example may be water. Water has certain small amount of viscosity. When it flows around a surface, then there exists an imaginary layer, and this within this imaginary layer, there is a presence of shear stress. But outside the layer, there is no shear stress, or we can neglect that shear stress. This particular layer is called the boundary layer. This boundary layer theory is responsible for the soil erosion. If you remember, because once you give the examples of ideal fluid, we generally say water. But water has certain kind of viscosity, small amount of viscosity. And this creates that boundary layer. Okay. So basically, what is boundary layer? Boundary layer generally forms when a fluid passed around a surface, then there exists an imaginary layer. Within that layer, there exists a velocity gradient. How? Because at the surface, the velocity will be zero. As you move upward, the velocity will move or increase. And this increment is seen only in a particular region. That particular region is called the boundary layer. Beyond that region, there is no velocity gradient. So beyond that region, there is no shear stress. Okay. So this is the basic idea of the boundary layer. Yeah, this is that particular layer. So this particular, this figure is taken for a closed curved surface. Now, if there is a flat surface, okay, this is our x-axis. This is our y-axis, okay. So when a fluid of the free stream velocity moves along this direction, and this is our surface, okay, so then there exists an imaginary layer in the neighborhood of the surface, and this is imaginary. This particular layer is called boundary layer. Within that boundary layer, there is a presence of viscosity, but outside the layer, there is no viscosity. Or we can say that inside the layer, there is a internal friction is there, but outside the layer, internal friction can be neglected. So this particular layer is called boundary layer. And this particular distance, this is called the boundary layer thickness. This is denoted by delta. So I would like to give one homework regarding that, not the home assignment, homework. You write down the definitions of boundary layer in a appropriate way. This is only for the understanding part. Then in the next class, we will see different types of boundary layer thicknesses are there. So with that, I would like to conclude.